video thu bởi camera Insta 360 độ,
đeo trước ngực làm body cam cùng với ba cái iPhone 12, 13 và 15 Pro Max.
Earphone required.
Scotty Sachs from Sovereign Radio, one of the six organizers, and thanks to you all for coming out today. We couldn't do this without you, and you're the reason we're here today. We're all coming together to take our border back.
Yes, we are. Listen, do you see what's behind you? Look, take a look. Look at the wall. Do you see it? Do you see it? Look straight out there in the sky. Not in the sky, but on the land. You see the wall. That's a border. That is a closed border right there. That's a safe, closed border right there. All right, so we all know why we're here today. So we're going to actually go through a little bit of housekeeping. So I'm so excited. Let me just get present to every single one of you. It is an honor to be here, to be standing beside you, and to hold the arms up of We the People. This isn't about us. This is about all of us. We, the people, coming together for such a time as this. I want to remind you that this is a peaceful, lawful assembly and prayer. Again, a peaceful, lawful assembly and prayer. I speak that out to all corners of this location right now. There will be peace. I will let you know that we will not put up with any infiltrators. We will not put up with any hate speech. None of that is allowed here. We are rolling in love. We are rolling in peace. We have so many people to thank here. I want to thank our police officers that are here today. You know, they have been a support. Come on, guys.
God bless the police.
I want to thank our military that's here. Retired
God bless the military.
There's so much to be thankful for. They have fought for this country. They have fought for our freedom. We're not going to let that freedom get taken away. I want to thank the truckers. The truckers behind the scene have been igniting the crowds. I want to thank the mama bears. The papa bears. What about the granddaddy bears and the grandmama bears? I want to thank the business owners. I want to thank every single one of you who have been in this battle with us. We have been in battle for quite some time. We've been waiting and waiting and waiting for something to happen, something to shift. And I think what we're learning is we are the shift. Yes. We the people are the shift, and when we're in alignment with God first and country, that is really key, you guys. So, a little bit of housekeeping. Now, we all know that sometimes potty breaks are important, and I'm a mom of four kids and a grandma. Potty just kind of comes out of my mouth. So, not really, but potty breaks. So, here's the deal. To behind me to the right, back there, you're gonna find the restrooms. You'll also find restrooms inside of the facility. So help yourselves. Yeah! I love it when they're beeping the horn. So good.
Thank God we got a convoy.
Yeah, baby. We're going to yell today, Scotty. So good, so good. All right, we we also have a communications table. It's a convoy table at the back of the house. You're going to have all the information you need to make the trek with us. We will be departing here on time at 12 noon. So that is our convoy time. We'll give you very clear instructions at the end so that you can be at peace and know exactly what steps to take. All right? All right, so we've talked potty breaks. We've talked the convoy, Scotty. We talked about making sure this is a peaceful, lawful assembly. Oh, protect the kids to the right of me. So that way. So guys, we've got some amazing groups here today that are all about protecting our kids, because let's just take a look. Isn't that what this is about? Protecting our kids? Yes? Yes. So you wanna go check them out? We've got some great stuff going on today. Scotty, I'm going back to you. Why are we here, Scotty?
So we're here because, does anybody think we have a national security crisis?
Yes.
Yes, indeed. Anybody who has talked to military or border agents, and I've interviewed a bunch of them on my radio show, when you ask them the question, is what happened in 2020 with BLM and Antifa very possible with these military-age men from 160 countries? Could they attack? Could these people hit us with terrorist attacks? And every military guy and border agent guy says, hell yeah, this is a national security crisis. We have a human trafficking problem, folks, on the border of proportions that we never imagined. The United States is the largest sponsor of human trafficking. That's not something we're proud of. $185 billion a year as an industry. And the fentanyl, we have someone here today that's gonna speak to her daughter dying of fentanyl. Fentanyl deaths in the last 3 years since this fake Biden administration has been opening the borders is more in 3 years than the previous 20 have died from fentanyl. So that's why we're here. We know we have a national security crisis. We got a few more problems, folks. We've got vets and elderly being displaced. Do you know that vets and elderly are being put on the street to house these people? Do you know schools are being cleared out? We're here to take a stand today to shine a light on this existential threat represented by open borders. Now, our federal government may be captured. Does anybody think our federal government's going to do anything about the open borders? But we have state and local officials who want to get reelected this year. And we're sending a message to them today. If you're listening, if you're here, maybe you're here in the crowd somewhere and you don't want to show your face, you're embarrassed by not taking a stand with these open borders. We're shining a light on you today. We're shining a light. Our local and state officials must take a stand. We're going to force them to take a stand. We're starting here and now today, right?
That's right, Scotty. Come on.
All right. So this event started with six of us. We got together. There were six of us who said, we got to do something. We can't sit around and do nothing. Turn into hundreds. We've been touched by thousands of people. We the people, just like you, from all over the country, we are grateful to the podcasters, the radio hosts, the social media influencers, independent journalists, and all of you who shared this on Facebook, Instagram, your text, your emails. The media coverage has been unbelievable. I've not seen an event quite covered by the media like this. Even CBS and NBC want to see what this is all about. Pretty interesting. The mainstream media is curious. We've been called Christo-fascist. Anyone know what that means?
Yeah,
I have no idea what it means.
He called me a nationalist Christian.
You're a white
I
nationalist.
I am from this nation, and I do love Jesus.
The truth is, we the people, somewhere in this crowd is my barber. He's from Iraq. His whole barbershop, they're Iraqis. They came here when they were young men. They're Americans first. We are not white nationalists. We are not Christo-fascists. We are we the people, the United States of America. Are we not?
Yes, we are.
So thank you all for coming. Enjoy the speakers, enjoy the entertainment, and most of all, enjoy the camaraderie of each other. Maybe you want to get a little closer together.
Yes.
Give somebody a hug that you never met.
Come on, squeeze on in. Get a little closer, you guys. Get a little closer. We're not doing the 6 feet apart thing. Sorry. All right. So we actually are going to, right now, we're going to have Pastor Eric from Victory Outreach lead us in prayer. And he's going to lead us in prayer in both English and in Spanish. Now, I am going to share something real quick. If anyone has parked across the street, just remember, it is at your own risk that you're parking. I'm from Boston. I said parking. Parking across the street. Okay, so just be aware of that. And Pastor Eric, let's get you up here. So honored to have you today.
Come on, can you make some noise this morning? I know you can do better than that. Come on, make some noise. Like you know we're taking our borders back. I want to read a portion of scripture before I pray, and it's found in the book of Nehemiah, verse 3 through 4. It says, they said to me, things are not going well for those who return to the province of Judea. They are in great trouble and disgrace. The wall of Jerusalem has been torn down, and the gates have been destroyed by fire. When I heard this, I sat down and wept. In fact, for days I mourned, fasted, and I prayed to the God of heaven. We are Nehemiahs this morning. And we're here to do the only thing that we know works, and that's pray. When we pray, God hears us. When we pray, heaven is moved and angels are mobilized and things begin to happen. And so this morning we're going to pray because this is a country that has been built on the Bible. This is a country that believes in God, and we're one nation under God, and we're going to stay that way. Can I hear somebody make some noise? So there where you are, whether you want to bow your head, close your eyes, or lift your hands, let's pray to God. Father, we come before you this morning, Lord, and we thank you that you are listening to us. We thank you that you are in this place, God. We declare this morning a move of your Holy Spirit over this nation, Lord. We pray, Lord God, that today we take back our borders, Lord, in the spirit. We begin, Lord God, to ask you, Lord, to move in the supernatural, Lord God. We pray, God, for every border that surrounds our country, Lord God. We pray and declare, God, that you will send, my God, protection to our families, to our children, Lord. We pray, Lord God, for this country, God. Oh, that was founded on the Bible, God. We pray, Lord God, that we will once again be a nation under God, Lord. We ask you, Lord God, that you would, my God, bring freedom and liberty, Lord. That you would protect, Lord God, our country, Lord. We declare and we pray peace over this country, Lord. We pray and declare that no weapon formed against us shall prosper, oh God. We declare, God, that you will protect every child, every family, Lord. We declare, Lord, this morning, God. Oh, we pray for those in the White House, God. Lord, as you change, God, the hearts of Nebuchadnezzar, God, the hearts of Saul of Tarsus, Lord. Oh, there isn't anybody that's too far away from your reach, Lord God. We pray for those that are making laws, God. We pray, Lord Jesus, that you would move upon their lives, that you would move upon their hearts, Lord. And today, Lord God, we pray, God, for heaven to be mobilized, God. We pray for angels to begin to move, Lord, on our behalf, Lord. And we pray that your presence would be here. We pray for America, Lord God. We pray for every state, Lord God. And we pray that today, Lord, not only heaven will hear us, but the country will hear us, Lord. And the White House will hear us, God. And you will move on our behalf, Lord. Te damos gracias esta mañana, Señor, por tu hermosa presencia en este lugar. Gracias por reunirnos de todas partes, Señor. Y declaramos esta mañana, Señor, que tú proteges nuestras familias, que tú proteges nuestros hijos, Señor. Declaramos, Señor, Padre, oh, Señor, que tú envías tus ángeles a acampar alrededor de esta gran nación, una nación fundada en la Biblia, Señor Padre. Te pedimos, mi Dios, Señor, que toques los corazones de aquellos en la Casa Blanca, aquellos en lugares de autoridad, Señor. Y declaramos esta mañana que tu presencia está aquí, Señor. Declaramos libertad. Declaramos, Señor, oh, que tú moverás el cielo a nuestra defensa. Oh, sí, Señor, te damos gracias esta mañana por lo que vas a hacer en esta gran nación de los Estados Unidos. En el nombre de Jesús, in Jesus' mighty name, we pray. And everybody says amen and amen.
Tammy Kelly. Good morning, you peace-loving, freedom-loving patriots. Thank you, Kim, for having me here. I'm from Nashville, Tennessee. And again, my name is Tammy Kelly, and my ministry is Flags in Motion. And so in 2023, this past January, the Lord had given me a vision, and it was very similar to what we're even seeing today, where patriots are gathered and they were worshiping and praising the Lord. And the banners that they were waving were very patriotic, but there were some very specific banners that I could see in this vision. And so the Lord had instructed me to design these and then to create them for the worship, and he called them worship banners. And so if you would like more information about my ministry and these banners, I have some samples over there that you can just find me later. But what we're here for is that we all have a fire in our belly for what is going on at the border and what this fake administration is allowing. So we're here to let our voices be heard. And the scripture tells us that our battle is not against flesh and bone, but it's against the powers of principalities of darkness. And so what that tells us is that there's actually a battle and there's an enemy. And so the Bible also gives us the history of wars and battles. And one of the things that we've learned is that before the army reached the battlefield, it was the flag bearers and the worshipers that went ahead of the army. And so when I think about the role of a standard bearer, there was many reasons why they waved their banners. And they would wave their banners as a way to boost a morale, to identify who they belong to, but also as a form of communication. And so we know that the scripture also tells us that the Lord is our banner, and his banner over us is love. And his love is our strength, and his love is our victory. And so as a spiritual standard bearer, it is time for us to engage in the spiritual warfare. It's time for us to communicate to the enemy that who we belong to, and that we're going to take this moment and we're going to worship and we're going to raise up a standard of freedom and liberty. And we're going to take the authority over this atmosphere, and we're going to declare the banner over us is God's love, his strength, and his victory.
Living in me, more powerful than anything that is in the world.
I love it, I love it. We got Turning Point USA out here. I see you. Come on. Okay, so we've got Lonnie in the middle. We've got Kelly right here. And we've got Rich. Now, these guys are going to shore you up and make sure you're ready to go. You guys, Mr. Police Officer, all of our police officers out there, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You guys are amazing. We love you. Thank you for protecting us. Thank you, thank you, thank you. They will make sure that it is a safe convoy. That's pretty rockin' awesome. All right, Kelly.
Welcome, everybody. Thank you for coming today. And we are going to be taking a route as suggested by the local police, because there will be far less stops, we can keep flowing, and the most important thing is to keep together, stay together. When we get on the freeway, go 55 or 60, let people kind of queue in, and what we're gonna do, instead of going this way through a lot of traffic, we're gonna go, when we exit the park, we'll be going right on Camino de la Paz. It just goes around about a mile and a half to the right. And then there's a stop sign, you gotta hit a T, and you turn right, and that will be Dairy Mart Road. We'll be led by one of the fine police officers here, and Rich will be in one of the lead vehicles here, followed by Kim and the rest of the convoy. I helped out on the People's Convoy about a year and a half ago, so it's really important that we stick together, and we have a route. We're gonna have a stop at El Centro, so let me just run through that real quick here as to the timing. So when you go right on Camino de la Plaza to the right, right on Dairy Mart, and you just go a short distance and you'll hit the 5 North, okay? So go 5 North for a short distance, then the 905 East to the 805 North, and then from the 805 North, we will go 8 East the rest of the way into Yuma. So the timing is as follows. We'll be departing here at about noon, so we can start lining up out here, and then we'll go in an orderly fashion and depart. And all this information in terms of the route, the ultimate route, is also on the website, takeourbordersback.com. There's actually a flyer with some of the instructions, the route, and the timing. So at about noon, start getting ready. If you need to use the bathroom, you want to get some food, you need to gas up quick, do that. We will be stopping in El Centro. So the timing will be getting out about noon, and then about 1:30, we'll be getting into the El Centro area, and we'll congregate there from 1:30 to 2, get back together, and when you get off in El Centro, get off at 4th Street, and you'll be taking a right and another right and going to the Superstop Travel Center.
Okay, so I got a question, because yes. I know everyone's going, that's a lot of details, and I'm just like, where do I go? They're going to be following somebody.
Follow the convoy, exactly.
Follow the convoy. And so Kelly, land this for me. Where are we meeting over here?
You can line up over here on Camino de la Plaza.
Okay, this road right here along the mall.
And then also this street to be heading out, and then we'll be going right when we exit. And if you're across the street in the mall area, you'll be turning left and going this way.
So are we going down this street right here?
Not right in front. It's Camino de la Plaza.
Oh,
it's the street out there.
Street out there. Okay, got it. So kind of where Ross is. That's
correct.
Right there.
And this is recommended by the local police. There's far less traffic signals, and it'll be a lot smoother in terms of getting onto the freeway. So once again, 5 North, 905 East, 805 North to the 8 East, and then we will be getting into El Centro about 1:30, exiting 4th Street, go right and right. We'll be going to the Superstop Travel Center. It's right next to In-N-Out Burger. It also has a lot of food places inside. If
awesome.
You need to use the restroom, get some food, get gas, and then at approximately 2 o'clock, once again, we'll be leaving as a group, going back towards the freeway, and then turning right and going 8 East on into Yuma, Arizona. And I also have an address for the endpoint. Once again, this is also on the website, but if you want to put the ultimate endpoint, that is 4330 Riverside Drive. Once again, 4330 Riverside Drive in Yuma. It's private property.
Yes, and you'll find it on the information table. So the convoy info, you'll see flyers there with that address. You can take a picture of it or take it with you. And also, just like Kelly said, you'll find it on takeourborderback.com. So you see that red FJ Cruiser out there? Straight ahead, right here, 12 o'clock for me.
With all the flags.
That's going to be my vehicle. So now there'll be a lead car in front of me to make sure we are going where we need to go. But I will be in that lead, and I'm so excited. I'm actually following a lead car, but I want you guys to know who I am. Scotty?
How did you get the lead and I get the tail?
You asked for the tail.
I did.
Okay, guys, so we're going to close it up right now. Guys, anything else to share? No, I want to thank.
Drive safely. Yeah. One other thing, have your headlights on. Don't necessarily have your flashers, but have your headlights on. Go 55 to 60. If some of the cars up front need to slow down a little bit until everybody gets queued in, try to stick together. Other cars can go past us, so try to stick together with the convoy. Far right lane, slow lane, lights on, and be safe. Obey all traffic regulations.
That's right.
Be safe. God bless you, and God bless America.
Amen. It's a peaceful, lawful assembly, and I'd like to say thank you to every single person who served today. Every single person who worked behind the scenes. I want to say thank you. Thank you to all of our volunteers. You guys, people that came here, in most cases, didn't get paid for a thing, right? It's pretty amazing that we've had all these volunteers. And I want to also thank all of you who've given to the givesendgo.com/takeourborderback. It's a big deal. We take full responsibility where every cent goes. And that is going to our convoys, and that is going to our rallies. I want you to know that God, I'm held accountable to God for what we do. Our whole team has made an agreement together. We are held accountable to God. We will do with what's right. And if you haven't read the givesendgo.com/takeourborderback, it's Haggai 2:8. The money is the Lord's. All right, guys, are you ready to convoy?
Yeah.
And we're going to finish with USA! 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 Woo! God bless you, and God bless this country. In Jesus' name.
Đây nè, ở này nè có hai máy nè.
Ba cái.
Ờ.
Được đi chung với Joe Biden đó.
Sao hay vậy?
Anh có quay nè ha. Anh này anh quay nè ha. Đây nè, xe này của anh có nè. Xe này của chị Thảo nè. Đó, đây thấy không? Mình đi xuống mình mới quay được. Đó, mình đi xuống dưới hết, thấy không? Mình mới thấy. Đó, quay vô trong này, Bắc Kinh họ đi ra nữa nè. Bây giờ mình quay lại đó thì mình kẹt.
Đúng rồi. À. Đi quay chút xíu, đi với nó chút xíu.
Đi với nó chút xíu ha.
Dạ. Yeah. Rồi sao gì không chứ mình đã đây rồi.
Ok.
Mình cũng phải về, mình cũng phải về sớm quá đâu.
Yeah.
Là mình trong cái cây kia.
Dạ, quay bên này nè.
Hả?
Mình quay được hai bên luôn.
Cô
ra ở Tennessee. Ồ, cái này mình phải đi theo cái đuôi. Chứ họ không có cho nói đây đâu, đi theo cái đuôi trong kia kìa.
Anh quen rồi
nghe
cho vô.
Dạ.
Thế nào mà có người nhà
mình. Đây nè, quay đây nè, quay bên này nè. Xe này nhiều cờ nè. Chừng nào nó vẫy mình mới được đi. Nó không vẫy thì mình cứ đứng chờ đây. Nó cho hai hàng. Ok, vậy được hả? Đi chỗ này quay đẹp nè. Thấy không? Quay cái xe, cái cờ nè. Yes. Hey, your truck is awesome. No, no, to the front of the line. Quay ngược xuống là chiếc xe. Đây là xe, xe này xe của anh có nè.
Anh ơi, anh lên trên là drop the mop đi anh ơi.
Hả?
Anh lên trên đó anh drop the mop.
Ok, ok, ok. Thì cứ quay như vậy đi. Tiếp tục quay đi, tiếp tục quay nè. Okay, I'll drop you up right here, okay?
Yes, please drop me up.
Tại vì khúc này là khúc cảnh sát. Cảnh sát nó dẫn đầu. Okay, I'll drop you up right here, okay?
Thank you. Yes.
Cô chui ra, cô rớt cái gì?
Cô rớt cô.
Thế con lợi con coi con rớt cái gì đây nè. Đây nè, nó rớt cái gì đen đen đây nè. Ồ, lấy cái vỏ gì đó. Để con ra con lấy.
Anh
cẩn
thận nhé. Dạ. Đau quá nhỉ. Nó còn đi xuống nữa kìa.
Dạ, đi xuống cuối cùng ạ.
À. Mình đứng đây mình đợi.
lắm ha.
Cái cô ở chiếc xe ngoài sao quá, cô rớt cái vỏ chìa khóa. Trời ơi, Mindy này.
Nó vậy đó anh à.
Cho em thả lòng ước mơ. Trời ơi, cái này là California đó thôi cô. Mình qua tới Arizona nó còn đông. Dự nữa đó, hả?
Đúng rồi, nó cứ nhập.
Qua bên Texas nó còn đông nữa. Để
đến người ta nhập nhau.
Anh quay thằng nhỏ nè.
À ha.
Nhỏ này hay nè.
Nó còn cái. Để cứ mua. Mỗi
lần cho nó đi kìa. USA. USA. Con xin phép mà. Cái chai nước trong cái vỏ con đó con. Cái vỏ vàng à. Không, con có chai nước nước trắng á cô.
Anh thấy dễ chịu hơn không?
Dạ dễ chịu hơn. Cảm ơn.
Anh đánh trước ngực anh một chút đi.
Kịp.
Anh cứ cho anh thâu thêm một đàn xong em coi cho. Mà vui thật.
Yeah. Đi qua bệnh đồng lắm.
Anh ơi.
Đi qua bệnh đồng lắm.
Em cảm ơn anh. Để làm driver cho mình. Tại sao hôm nay sướng vậy? Yeah.
Bình thường là phải.
Ơi, cảm ơn anh quá.
Hôm nay có hai người YouTuber này được đi chung với Joe Biden. Vô đây nè. Rồi có một cọc vẹt rồi, chưa chạy trước rồi đã không?
for watching.
Let's go, Brandon. Let's go, Brandon. Let's go.
This video has been edited by iMovie Lore.
Lamb Tram.
Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar!
Có sáu một diễn tham.
Càng nghe nhiều càng tiêu 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 tiêu.
Ta tiên đình sư đoàn nhảy dù.
Càng nghe nhiều càng tiêu.
Quan càng to, cu càng teo mo.
Thằng lính dù nào nói khi nhảy dù chim không teo thằng đó xạo.
Mà đa số chúng nó nói xạo thiệt.